नमस्ते, दिस इज जेबीएन डॉक्टर विशाल सक्सेना, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन मैथमेटिक्स एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स इन जयति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द मॉड्यूल हिस्टोग्राम। दिस मॉड्यूल हिस्टोग्राम इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द कोर्स बायो स्टैटिस्टिक्स अंडर द प्रोग्राम ऑफ द एमएससी एनएनडी, एमएससी बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, एमएससी एफएसटी, एमएससी माइक्रोबायोलॉजी फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी। एंड दिस पार्ट ऑफ द हिस्टोग्राम इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ द मैथमेटिक्स एंड स्टेटिस्टिक्स एंड हैविंग द वेरियस एप्लीकेशंस इन डिफरेंट फील्ड्स। So in the today session we are going to discuss about the concept of the histogram and how can we it draw, what are the applications of the histogram, and examples will be discussed there. So a histogram is a part of the graphical representation of data or the frequency distribution. So means as all we know that graphical representation consists of many type of different figures like the histogram and the bar diagram, pie chart, and many more other curves like frequency polygon. So histogram is a part of the graphical representation of data, and it will just explain the histogram is also a type of the bar diagram, but in histogram the rectangles all the buildings in a graph paper or in the pictorial representation of data are just attached to one another, while which is not necessary that in the case of the bar diagram. And in the histogram the area of the rectangles just are proportional to the frequency of the data just shown along the vertical axis, and also proportional to the width of the rectangle, that means which is written by along the horizontal axis, and it will shown by the class interval. So that is just its area is proportional to the proportional to the frequency as well as the class intervals width. And this histogram is an important part of the graphical representation of data, and which can be used to explain the shape and size of the distribution of the data. Means we can understand what type of frequency distribution we have. So what is the shape of that distribution, what should be the shape of the distribution, and in that way we can understand it. And this histogram is also useful various applications in even management and the banking sector, is also in the economy of the country, and so many different type of applications can be understood with the histogram. So today session we are going to discuss about this, and we take now some slides to explain it with mathematical and statistical part and with some example and its diagram. So initial we are given that the histogram's definition and their uses and its uses. So in the histogram is a diagram involving rectangles whose area is proportional to the frequency of a variable and width is equal to the class interval. So histogram is a kind of the diagram, and just which involves rectangles, as all we know that it is a figure with just consisting of rectangles or the bars, and its area will be proportional to the frequency of the variable, and width is equal to the class interval. Now, very important part of the applications or the uses of the histogram. So a histogram is used to check the shape of the data distribution. So means just by the histogram we can analyze the shape of the distribution, the frequency distribution. We can understand what should be its shape. Used to check whether the process changes from one period to another. So in the second point, we can understand, we can study, like we can use it to check whether the process changes from one period to another. So it means the change we can understand here from one period to another by this histogram. Third point, used to determine whether the output is different from when it involves two or more processes. Sometimes we can see our distribution is having two or more different processes. So if our frequency distribution or our process, our method just will have the two or more different processes, then the histogram can be used to determine whether the output is different. So it is a very important part of the application, because for the two or more processes it can be used to find whether the output is different. Number four point, used to analyze whether the given processes meet the customer requirements. So it is an important point because histogram can be used with so many applications. So one of the application means the customer requirements is shown there, and so in the customer requirements if the customer requirements are represented by the histogram, then we can analyze the whole process with the needs of the customer and their requirements. So that type means this histogram is a very useful process, and by it we can understand the whole distribution, whole frequency distribution in a summary part, and it will reveal so many things for the frequency distribution. Now we are taking the part of the types of the histogram. So histogram, we are discussing about the types of the histogram, and in which the first point is taken for the uniform histogram. So uniform histogram is a part of the histogram, and you can see the figure by which we can understand what type of uniform histogram is representing there, and what it represents. A uniform distribution reveals that the number of classes is too small. So it is very important type of the histogram, and it shows that the number of classes is too small. We can see the number of classes are very very small, and each class has the same number of element, and each class is having the same number of elements, and it may involve distribution that has several peaks. So it is a kind of the distribution which consists of several peaks, means different peaks will be included there, will exist there, and we can show by this figure of the uniform distribution. So the main points of this distribution are that is just it will have the number of classes too small, and each class has the same number of elements. Like we can see there, in this uniform histogram, the initial three bars are shown that with the same peak, with the same height. The fourth is different, the next fifth is different, sixth is different, but next two just bars are having the same peaks, then the next three having the same peaks. So just this type of the histogram is known as uniform histogram. Next is the bimodal histogram. In this bimodal histogram, we can see the two there are two parts of the histogram, and now we understand what is showing by this figure. If a histogram has the two peaks, we can see there it is having the two peaks, it is said to be bimodal. So if a histogram has two peaks, then it is called bimodal histogram. And bimodality occurs when the data set has observations on two different kinds of the individuals. So in this histogram, the data set will have has the observations on the two different kinds of individuals or the combined groups. If the centers of the two separate histograms are far enough to the variability in both the data sets. So we can see there in this type of the bimodal of histogram, the data sets has the observations on the two different kinds of individuals or the combined groups, and if the centers of the two separate histograms are far enough to the variability in the both data sets. So like we can understand this type of the bimodal histogram means it will have the two peaks and the data set has the two observations, like has observations on the two different kinds of individuals. Now next is that symmetric histogram, and we can see this a kind of the symmetric histogram in which we can understand a symmetric figure is shown, that a symmetric bars are shown, that if we take at the center, if we just consider a vertical line just from the center of this histogram, then along this center line, the left side and the right side portion of the histogram will be just symmetrical, that is two symmetrical. So that's why it is called a symmetric histogram. So when you draw the vertical line down the center of the histogram and the two sides are identical in size and shape, so the two different sides on the left side and on the right side of this vertical line, we can observe that these two sides are exactly identical in their shapes also and their size also, then such type of the histogram is known as the symmetric histogram. And fourth is the probability histogram. A probability histogram shows a pictorial representation of the discrete probability distribution. So actually it shows a pictorial representation of the discrete probability distribution, and which consists of a rectangle centered on every value of x, and the area of each rectangle is proportional to the probability of corresponding value. So this kind of histogram is used for the discrete probability distribution. Discrete probability distribution means where the random variable will have the finite values and where the area of each rectangle will be proportional to the probability of the corresponding value. So in the today's session, we have discussed about the part of the histogram, and which is a very important part of mathematics and statistics, and students are advised to what is histogram and what are the various applications of histogram and how can we draw it, because first we have to understand how to draw it with the given frequency distribution, with the given data. And next to that, students must have to learn about their application part, because histogram is a very important part, and this part has so many applications in various practical applications also and in very different fields. So like the of marks obtained by the students in the economical field, in the market field, we can just see there are so many examples just can be seen in the books and in on the different different areas where we can see such type of examples. So we have to understand what are the applications of such histograms in different fields, because it is a very important part. And practice for objective as well as the descriptive questions. Thank you.